Very rainy morning to all of you. It's raining heavily since night, since 2 days, I guess. For 2 days, sorry. Now let's continue with the chapter. Fine, and very apt to the weather we are facing these days. But we cannot compare this weather with the weather which you can say was faced by Prashant and all the members of that village. Fine. So we are reading the chapter Weathering the Storm in Arzama. Fine. The correct pronunciation is Arzama. So in this chapter, we have read so far that how the protagonist, it's still joining. Let me please note down the points written on the board if in case you have joined lately. So please. You can see the very first point we have read so far. Anybody can tell me the story? Anybody? If I explain before that, if anybody would like to speak some few lines on that, please raise your hand. I will give you the chance to speak. Only one child always say. I want different child. Same time, Diksha always answers all the questions and ready to give answers. So others also should give it a try. Others are not at all participating. Yes, Divya, can you speak?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
On 27 October 1999, Prashant went to his friend's house to meet him, but and he decided to come back by evening. But in the evening, there the cyclone came in Odisha. The water filled up to the neck. Prashant and his friend's family decided to go on the roof. Many trees were uprooted and many people died and many animals were also seen. A tree fell on their house and they got food to eat as they were very hungry for several days.
So coconut trees fell. Yes, right.
After that, Prashant decided to go back to his village and he was also worried about his family. He took a strong stick and decided to go to his village, which was a little bit far. In the
Okay, fine, Divya, thank you so much. So we have read so far exactly Divya has mentioned, and he has to come back 18 kilometers he has to travel. So he took a sturdy stick to wade the water away, and throughout the way he met two men of his same village who were the two acquaintances, and he was happy to see ki, okay, their company is there. So all three of them, they started their journey from there. Then when he reached his own village, Kalikuda, name of the village. Fine, and he was so scared that by seeing the dead bodies of, you can say, carcasses of animals and corpses of human beings throughout the way, he was scared that whether he was able, he'll be able to meet his family or not. So he was happy to see his extended family was there. His maternal grandmother came there to hug him, and she was so happy to see that he was alive. They were thinking that Prashant is no more because he had gone to see his friend. So he met his other uncle and aunts and siblings. So he went to that Red Cross, so you can say camp was there for all the people who left. You can say most of the houses were broken and all the things were washed away. Most of the houses were washed away. Even the, you can say, things of Prashant's own house could be seen stuck in the tree branches. And he was so, you can say, feeling, he was so shocked to see his own house. You can say the remains of the house floating in the water and stuck in the branches of the tree. So then now we are going to what we are going to read today. These points are written on the board. Okay. So this is what we have read in the previous days, last 2 days, and now what we are going to read today. Please note down the points. Protagonist is Prashant. We all know that protagonist, main character. Then Prashant reached Kalikuda. We are going to continue from that. He reached his village, Kalikuda, and then he goes to Red Cross shelter. So the people over there, they had, you know, created a shelter wherever where all the people who were able to save their lives, they were there. Okay. And then he goes to Red Cross Short. After that, he meets his family also over there. And then 86 lives were lost in this, in his only, in his own village. Okay. This data belongs to his own village, Kalikode. So 86 people lost their lives in that horrible incident. And 96 houses washed away. 96 houses were washed away in that horrible incident. Then Prashant, you know, he was earlier, he was very dejected. He was so emotional. Already, you know that he has lost his mother many years ago, 8 years ago. And he thought that he will be losing his family members also to this. But he, when he saw his family members waiting for him, he was satisfied, but he did not feel that satisfaction for other people also. He was empathizing with others. He, what about others? They have many children lost their parents. Many parents lost their children. Many women became widow. Many children became orphaned, right? So problem was that he thought that nobody, you know, was leading them. People of the village were very innocent. They were not getting any direction what to do next, because everything was distorted. Everything was in chaos. So he decided ki I should be the leader. So that's why I've written, he, Prashant decides to take the charge. He thought ki two things are there. I should cry over the things, or I should take the charge. So he, you know, compiled all the emotions and kept it aside. And he decided ki I will take the charge. I will do something for the sake of my village. And then he decides to lead the crowd. Okay. Because in the crowd, you know that crowd here means because people were already mentally not stable after losing their loved ones. Many lost their animals, many lost their children. So they were not in a right mental condition. So what Prashant faced throughout the way while reaching the village, and what he eyewitnessed in his own village, he decided definitely I will help my village people anyhow. Clear? So now I'll be sharing the screen with you all, and we will continue reading. I will now, you know, increase the speed accordingly. I will be reading myself, then I can ask any one of you to continue also. So please keep your eyes on the book only. Or if you do not have the book right now, please keep your eyes on the screen. So by the next morning, as he took in the desperate situation in the shelter, he decided to get a grip over himself, fine? He sensed a deathly grief settling upon that 2,500 strong crowd in the shelter. 86 lives were lost in the village. All the 96 houses had been washed away. Underline this data, beta. It was their fourth day at the shelter. So far, they had survived on green coconuts, but there were too few to go around such a tumult of people, right? So there was such a chaos, tumult of people here means great rush of people was there. You can say disorder was there. Tumult here means, please underline the word tumult of people. Only underline the word tumult. Tumult here means that disorderly crowd, okay? Disorder. So chaos, jisko keh dete hain, chaos. So there were a lot of chaos, koi lead nahi kar raha tha. Only they were having green coconuts from the fallen trees. They were surviving, and maybe up to 2,500 people were there in one shelter, and they were not having anything to eat. They were not having any, you can say, toilets to use. They were not having basic, you know, clothes to change. So 4 days ho chuke the unko, and there should be something for them. So Prashant, all of 19 years, please note down the age of Prashant. Now we got to know the exact age. Here they have mentioned, earlier they have not mentioned. Exactly, a young boy, a young man, they are using this word only, but now they have mentioned the age of Prashant, clear? So Prashant, all of 19 years, decided to step up as a leader of the village if no one else did. He organized a group of youth and elders to jointly pressurize the merchant once again to part with his rice. Clear? So Prashant, see, just a 19-year-old boy who is deciding to step up as a leader of the village, because, you know, that's why yesterday we discussed the quote, difficulties do not come to destroy you, they come to check how difficult you are. Two types of responses you can give to difficulties. First response is you just sit up over there and watch over. And second type of response is that you have to take the charge, you have to take the lead. So Prashant decided the second part. So he decides that I will be helping my village people. So he, what he did, he organized a group of friends from this own village, Kalikuda. And he also asks, you can say asked one of the other elders, many elders of his own village. And they make a, you can say within few minutes, he made up a group, fine. So he, this time the delegation succeeded and returned triumphantly. They decided that there was one merchant in the village. So see how smart that boy was. He thought the first and foremost necessity of the people, abandoned people, was to get the food. So he decided to talk to the merchant of the village who was having, you can say, rice. So he decided, I will talk to the merchant and he has to give us rice firstly. And then I will work upon the secondary things. First is food. Fine, food and shelter are the both things. Shelter they were having. So now they wanted food. No one cared that the rice was already rotting. Branches from fallen trees were gathered to light a reluctant and slow fire on which to cook the rice. For the first time in 4 days, the survivors at the cyclone shelter were able to fill their bellies. So see, he convinced the merchant by saying that already the village is distorted. Many people lost their lives. If to whom you will sell your rice? Fine. So see that smartness of this young boy. So he convinced, he, it means he had very good convincing power. He convinced the merchant to give him rice and everybody was able to eat food properly that day. So his next task was to organize a team of youth volunteers. Who is a volunteer? Anybody knows? Who's a volunteer? Nobody can answer? Please, quick responses. Raise your hand. I will unmute you and you can speak at that time. Yes, Titiksha, who is a volunteer? You raised hand for this.
Who are a part of a group or a union? People who are a part of group or a union.
Voluntarily, with their own wish. This is main you think you need to enter. Yes, very good. You tried. Those are part of some group or society, but they are leading it. They are participating in with their own wish. Nobody is forcing them. Apni marzi se. Fine. So he, you know, again organized youth volunteers to clean the shelter of filth, urine, vomit, and floating carcasses, and to tend to the wounds and fractures of the many who had been injured. So first thing Prashant did, he convinced the merchant to give rice and they cooked rice for everyone. They ate food. Fine. So in 4 days, first meal they had was rice. Second thing, then he decided ki I will organize a group of youth volunteers jo apni marzi se aage aayenge, and they decided to clean the filth. Filth means garbage. You know, because everything was distorted after the cyclone. So vomitings and floating carcasses, carcasses already discussed, dead bodies of animals. So dead bodies of animals were there. Many people were wounded. They got many bones were fractured. So they decided that firstly, cleanliness now is our second concern after giving the food. So he and other group of members, they decided that we will cleaning the place and we will be attending to the ones who got serious injuries in this cyclone. Okay, is it clear to you all? Keep on responding. Okay, fine, better. So on the fifth day, a military helicopter flew over the shelter and dropped some food parcels. It then did not return. Fine. Then you know that what happens when such kind of emergency is there, what does the government do? Government provides, you know, food from, you can say, when they are not able to reach the area where flood is there, where cyclones are there, where they cannot enter by the road, then they throw packaged food from the helicopters only. Fine. So on the fifth day, a military helicopter flew over the shelter and dropped some food parcels. It means now military men are knowing that these villages are, you know, in a very pathetic condition and they are in need of food. So packaged food was dropped from the helicopter. It then did not return. See, once it threw, do you think that one packet will be sufficient for them? The youth task force gathered. You can see in this picture. See the pathetic condition. I will be discussing the idea of Prashant also in this picture. You can see that how a family is standing with their hands towards the sky. they want to get the food. And three boys are lying on the ground with plates on their tummy. So this is actually an idea. So when helicopter moves from that above that place, they thought that when they will be lying with fine utensils and, you know, with sun reflection, they will be able to capture the attention of the helicopter, that their people are lying. Helicopter will get a sign that population is there, because it is very difficult to, you know, get the attention from that distance. So they decided this idea that they will be lying on the ground with plates on their tummies and belly, so that helicopters can get an idea that people are still in need of food, right? So that was decided by Prashant and other volunteers. So you can see in this picture now. So they get the utensils from the shelter. Then they deputed the children to lie in the sand left by the waters around the shelter. So they decided that children will be lying fine on the ground by keeping the plates on their bellies and with these utensils on their stomachs to communicate to the passing helicopters that they were hungry. So actually this was a sign of their hunger. Fine, plate, keeping the plates on their stomachs, it is a kind of gesture of communication that they need food, okay? And then the message got through. Definitely helicopters, they got the message. And after that, helicopter made regular rounds of the shelter, airdropping food and other basic needs. So this idea did work. So this idea of Prashant did work. And he got food. They started throwing blankets and fine. They started getting airdropping food and other basic needs, whatever was required, soap or you can say clothing and blankets. So they started getting from helicopter. So next, see the efforts of this 19-year-old boy, Prashant. Prashant found this paragraph I have highlighted. Prashant found that a large number of children had been orphaned. He brought them together and put up a polythene sheet shelter for them. Women were mobilized to look after them while the men secured food and materials for the shelter. So this third thing now we did. Firstly, he arranged, you can say, rice. Remember the deeds done by Prashant. Secondly, he organized a group of boys and elders who started cleaning the place. Thirdly, he decided to, you know, communicate with the helicopters to get food and other basic things. Now, at the fourth place, he, you know, collected all the children who lost both their parents in that cyclone, because nobody was there to take care of these children. Fine, kisi ke father ki death hui thi, kisi ke mother ki, but there were children who lost both the parents. So he decided ki I will be collecting all those orphan children, and then he, you know, gave the responsibility to the women in the shelter to take care of these children, and men were organizing or securing food and other materials for these people. Right. So this is another good deed done by Prashant. Clear? As the weeks passed, this is what we are going to read now. As the weeks passed, Prashant was quick to recognize that the women and children were sinking deeper and deeper in their grief. Now, see, earlier when that calamity occurred, when that cyclone happened, they were in a shock. What to do, how to save our lives, and then how to get the food and basic things. But now when they were living in such poor circumstance for so many days, then slowly and steadily grief started, you know, hovering over them. They were getting depression and dejection. And he persuaded the women to start working in the Food for Work program started by an NGO. NGO means non-government organizations. So one NGO came forward for their help. And for the children, he organized a sports event. See, so now he started working for the mental health of the children. Firstly, he was working for physical health of the people. Now he started working for the mental health. He started organizing sports for the children so that they can, you know, they won't think about their lost parents and their lost siblings or other things. And he also engaged the women. They started working with an NGO. And he himself loved to play cricket, and so he organized cricket matches for children. Prashant engaged with other volunteers in helping the widows. Fine, though the widows are the ones who lost their husbands and children to pick up the broken pieces of their lives. The initial government plan was to set up institutions for orphans and widows. However, this step was successfully resisted, as it was felt that in such institutions, children would grow up without love and Widows would suffer from stigma and loneliness. Prashant's group believed orphans should be resettled in their own community itself, possibly in new foster families made up of childless widows and children without adult care. Now, please listen to this carefully. Government of that area, that state, they decided ki what they will do. They will send the orphan children, you know, to the widows, widows who lost their husband, and they will get find someone to take care of. So this was the idea of the government. But Prashant and other volunteers, that group believed that we will not send these children to the widows anywhere in the other state or in any other village. He thought if we will send our orphan children to other states or other places, it will be a stigma and loneliness. You know, when you have to leave your own place, when you have to leave the place you are living, it is very difficult. Already they lost their parents, and if they have to leave the village also, they will be very sad. So he says that no, I want orphans should be resettled in their own community. Fine. He says that let's see foster families. Foster families are the ones, you know, who will take care of a family that provides custody for children. Foster families are those families who take the responsibility of taking care of the orphaned children. Fine. Ya fir jin bachcho ko kisi ne chhod diya hota hai, zaruri nahi orphaned hi ho, they can take care of any child. Fine. And they are the foster family. So he decided, Prashant says that we will not send our children to any other widows to the other states. I think we should make them settle in their own community itself. Unki apni community mein bahut sari foster families hain. There are some people, there are some couples who do not have kids, fine? They cannot have due to some health issues. So he says many families can come up, they can take charge of these children, or many widows are there in their own community also. And there are children without adult care in our own community also. So we match our community ke bachcho ko apni hi community ke ladies ke saath ya families ke saath match karwayenge rather than sending them outside. So it is 6 months after the devastation of the super cyclone. So this idea is not coming to at that time when that devastation occurred. Actually, it is 6 months after the devastation of the super cyclone. Okay. So this time Prashant's wounded spirit has healed simply because he had no time to bother about his own pain. His handsome, youthful face is what the widows and orphan children of his village seek out most in their darkest hour of grief. So, it was only a ray of hope for the villager was Prashant himself. How he managed to, you know, help everyone in that, he himself, you know, lost his mother many years ago. So he knows already the, you know, pain of separation. How does it feel after losing your parent, one of the parents or both parents? So he decided that the kind of, you know, pain I felt, I don't want, you know, others to feel and go through the same pain. So after, you know, solving the basic needs and providing them houses, then he decided ki I will definitely help my people of village by getting the foster families for the orphan children or by finding the parents for the orphan children. And he used to play cricket with them. He used to provide them mental support, physical support, emotional support. And, you know, the best way to keep yourself happy is by helping others. You know, you just try to help anyone in any, the person who's in dire need of your help, just help them. And then you will realize that how, you know, good it feels. We people these days, we feel so cool, you know, by spending money on branded clothes. We are into, you know, showbiz. Like we should show off by buying materialistic things and putting it on social media and, you know, highlighting it. So rather than if you can, you are having the resources with you, whatever meager resources, or if you can arrange others also, you can form a group also that to help the other members of the society. So then after helping others, the kind of feeling comes to you that is beyond explaining. Okay. So, any doubt to anyone, beta? Clear? No doubt is there? All clear? Send me thumbs up immediately. I'm going to see those who are present, those who are attending the class, those who are visible, they need not send. Those who are switched on the videos, like I can see Deepkirti and Rishikesh. Fine, they were attentive throughout, I was able to see. Try to switch on the videos, okay? Jo bhi bachche baithe hote hain, they need to, it seems very interactive to the teacher also. So most of you are sitting there. That's good. So we are not having much time now, only 2 minutes are there. We won't be able to do so many questions. Now you tell me what you have learned from the story. Now your interaction, you raise your hand. Diksha hand raise nahi karegi ab bas, aur koi karega. So you have participated a lot, Diksha, that's why I'm not giving chance to you. Deepkirti, if you would like to tell, or Rishikesh, you would like to speak, that what you have learned from this chapter. Anything, what you have learned from this chapter. Okay. Yes, Rishikesh?
Ma'am, the thing which I have learned from the chapter, we should not to get panic in the very difficult situations. We should not to lose hope in the difficult times.
Very good. So we should never lose hope in difficult times, and we should not lose our presence of mind also. Yes, Deepkirti, would you like to speak? Is it possible for you? Then please speak. If it's not possible, that's okay. Anybody else? Pushti, what you have learned from this story? Okay, Deepkirti, no problem. No problem. You are unable to unmute yourself, Deepkirti, no problem. Pushti, you can speak, beta. Dhairya Chadda, are you there? What you have learned from the story? Those who are not responding, what does it mean? Are they sleeping? Still lying in the quills? Yes. Not working. See n number of reasons are popped up in my chat box. It's not working, that not working. Surveen, how are you now? Be a stone face winds of difficult times. Yes, Deepkirti. Stone to face winds difficult times. Yes, we have to be very strong to face difficult times. That is the learning of Deepkirti. Jia Mago. Yes, we should be courageous and have confidence in every phase of life. Yes, we have to be courageous, brave, and we should be ready to face any situation. Very good. Jia. Who else want to speak or write? I will be naming the child who is typing in the chat box. And those who want to speak can raise their hand. So time ho chuka hai beta aapka, 12 o'clock exactly. So I have had next period also. So please have a nice day. Okay. And what you are now supposed to do, please solve the question answers clear on the book. So in the next lecture, and Riyanshika says, we must always face challenges together regardless of the community we belong to. Very good. Okay. So in any community we are residing, we should not think about our own community. We should help others without thinking about it. Okay. So please solve the questions, and next time we will discuss with this. Lisa says, we should not lose hope. Okay, beta. So I spoke all the messages sent by you. Have a nice day.